Oh yeah, family, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration, Morning Motivation. I am Deacon Ford, and we're here once again to give God all glory, all honor, all praise. For this right here is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice. I'm going to say that again, just in case you ain't hear me the first time. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's morning time, family. Let's get into this word and see what the word say, y'all. It is morning time. Okay. Sister Lucy, I see you on here. Mother Horton, it is morning time. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. And happy birthday to you, Mother Horton. Sister Lucy, good morning to you. I see you on here, Money. Good morning to you. It's morning time, baby. It is morning time. You see it? Deacon Doc. Brother Mike, Big Mike, what's up, brother? Good morning to you. It's morning time. Okay. Good morning to you. It is morning time. What's up, Pree? Good morning to you, bro. Morning time. Happy birthday, mother. It's morning time. Oh, yeah. Listen, y'all, it is morning time. Welcome to the celebration, Morning Motivation. Welcome to the Morning Motivational family. Well, what are we celebrating, Deacon Ford? Listen, if God, nobody ain't told you, this morning right here, we are celebrating the breath of life that is in our lungs. God has blessed us. He allowed us to see another day, y'all. If some people laid down last night, they didn't get up this morning. If some people right now, they trying to figure out funeral arrangements and things like that. And despite the situation and despite how things may be looking, we are here to see another day. And we thankful, man. We thankful. We thankful for God's grace and his mercy for allowing us to be here. Good morning to each and every single. Shout out to my man T-Money. Shout out to you this morning, T-Money. Shout out to my brother Emery. Shout out to Sister Carr, Sister Pam. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. God is great and he is worthy to be praised. Y'all come in right quick, man. Everybody come in. Come in. I need everybody to come in real close so I can put my arm around all y'all, man. Big hug to y'all. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. My brother Chris, good morning to you. Good morning, good morning, good morning to each and every single one of y'all, man. One more time for that boy T-Money. Good morning to you, bro. I appreciate each and every one of y'all who hit that share button. Listen, you don't understand. When you hit that share button, you sending the word out. It's going out. It may reach somebody who may never had an opportunity to hear the word, or even see the word presented in this fashion, man. Because, you know, Morning Motivation, we a big family, huh? And we don't come from perfect backgrounds. Some of us still caught up in some things that we still trying to work out, but that don't mean that God don't love us. And that don't mean that God don't have a plan for our life and a purpose for our life. And so it is vitally important that you get around people that you can relate to and people that understand where you're coming from and people that can help point you in the right direction. And that's what I'm here to do this morning. This morning, y'all, without any further delay, this morning, we're looking at Colossians, y'all. Colossians chapter 4, verses 2 through 6. Colossians chapter 4, verses 2 through 6. Shout out to my sister Hall. My sister Odessa, my big sis, my cousin Erica, sister Alicia, man, y'all popping in. I'm trying to get everything started, man, but I just see the love. I feel the love and the energy this morning, man. And I love y'all. I want y'all to know that y'all motivate me. Man, I got to say this here right quick. So Sunday, my brother Pree, man, shout out to Pree, bro. You know I love you, man. He popped in Sunday, surprised me. I had an opportunity to kick it with him a little bit. And, man, bruh said something. We was together. Me and Pree was together a few weeks, probably a couple months ago. And we were supposed to meet up. We had some business to take care of. And I was running a little bit late. And so, you know, I apologize. Once we got together, he got in the car. I apologized to bro. And Pree said something, man. And I just hear his voice all the time. And it's such motivation. Pree said, I was running late. And I said, bro, I apologize to you, man. You know that I kept you waiting. And Pree said, man, you don't need to apologize to me. He said, man, you deserve to sleep in. Each and every morning you get up and you speak to the world. Boom! Boom! Hey, appreciate, man, each and every morning you get up and speak to the world. You deserve to sleep in sometime. And boy, talking about pouring kerosene on the fire. Man, that man, you lit me up, man. So shout out to y'all and each and every single one of y'all and y'all own way. Y'all motivate me to keep going, bruh. And sis, y'all motivate me to keep going, man. This morning, Colossians chapter 4. Verses 2 through 6. This morning, Colossians chapter 4, verses 2 through 6. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you once again for your grace and your mercy as we come to you in the mighty name of your Son, Christ Jesus. Our prayer this morning that as we gather together in this fashion, that you will bless us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that we read, that your Holy Spirit will guide us in all truth and revelation. We thank you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Colossians chapter 4, verses 2 through 6. The word reads, continue earnestly in prayer, being vigilant in it with thanksgiving. Meanwhile, praying also for us that God would open to us a door for the word, to speak the mystery of Christ, for which I am also in chains, that I may make manifest as I ought to speak. Walk in wisdom toward those who are without, redeeming the time. Let your speech always be with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer each one. May God add a blessing to the reader and the hearer, but most importantly, the doer of his holy word. The Apostle Paul opens up and saying, continue earnestly in prayer, being vigilant in your prayer with thanksgiving. Continue in prayer. Always be in prayer, man. Prayer is the most important thing that you have. Prayer can take you from one place in your life to another one because you have that open communication with God. And when you pray, take time to meditate so that you are in a space that when God speaks to you, you'll be able to hear what he is saying. And when you hear it, then you have to do it. The Bible tells us not just be hearers of the word, but be doers of the word also. So he is stressing it right now. He is saying continue earnestly, intently, fervently. He said in prayer, being vigilant in it with thanksgiving. And meanwhile, pray for us also that God would open a door for us in the word to speak the mystery of Christ, for which I am also in chain. Man, listen, when you praying, man, make sure you praying for me, bro. Hey, sis, you over there, right there. You right there. Make sure that you are praying for me. As the Apostle Paul said, that God will open the door for the word that I may go out and continue to spread this word, man. It ain't about me. I just want to be used as a vessel, man. Listen, when I was with the devil, when I was riding with him, I let him use me however he felt, huh? I wasn't shy about what I did. I wasn't ashamed about what I did. I was out there doing it. And I only got to put that out there because there's some people on this live right now that know me from when I used to do what I used to do. My name still, I go to the town right now. I go home right now, man. And my name, they know me. Who in town? What? Yeah, what? They come. They come around because I'm one of the ones that survived that. I'm still here. And then on top of the fact that I survived, I'm on the Lord's side. I'm on the Lord's side with it. I'm on the Lord's side with it. So as you pray, man, pray for me. Pray for each other. Pray one for another. Pray for the ones that are going through. It's a lot of people who've lost people right now. It's a lot of people who are dealing with confusion and chaos, not only within their own communities, but some of them within their own homes. And some of them are dealing with confusion and chaos within their own selves. Y'all don't forget, man, this month right here, May, is Mental Health Awareness Month. May is Mental Health Awareness Month. We got people who are going through, man, pray one for another. He said that I may speak the mystery of Christ, for which I am also in chain. Man, the apostle Paul went to jail behind this word, man. He was so bold, and they ain't want him to preach the word. They ain't want him to spread the word and the love of God and the mystery of Jesus Christ and how God, he was the only begotten son of God, and how he hung and died for our sins, and he was resurrected from the dead, because they didn't want him to preach it. He went boldly in regard and disregard of what they wanted, and they locked him up because they knew, the people knew, that God had sent his son and raised his son from the dead, and the same power that he used to raise him from the dead, that you and I can possess this same power. They knew that that would change the world, and they kept locking him up. They didn't want him. And so he said, and I'm in chains. And right now we are in chains. Those of us who have put our lives to the side, that we may get this word out to as many people as possible, that I may make it manifest as I ought to speak it. He said, walk in wisdom toward those who are without wisdom, man. Come on now. Some of us be falling for the okie doke. Some of us stay falling for the okie doke. As soon as somebody pop off, you pop off right with them, and then you crash and burn. You find yourself waking up the next morning saying, dang, what I did? You got a big lump on your eye. Huh? You done lost all your money because you had to bond out of jail. You done wrecked your car. Your wife done left. Your husband done left. Kids don't want nothing to do with you. It says, walk in wisdom toward those who without wisdom. You got to deal with them accordingly. Everybody ain't on the level. So that means sometimes you got to step back, or you got to step down, so you could deal with them accordingly. That's how you got to do it. You got to step back. You can't always meet fire with fire. You got to meet fire with water so you can put the fire out, man. Come on, bro. Stop crashing out. Stop crashing out, sis. It's 2021. We in May, almost finna be in June, half of the year almost gone. We approaching 2022. Stop crashing out. It's a wrap for the foolishness. Reflection, accountability, and preparation. We're getting prepared to walk into our purpose and fulfill our destiny. It's time to stop crashing out, man. Y'all listen, I'm going in this morning. I thank God for he using me. Let your speech be always be with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how you ought to answer each one, man. Being mindful, huh? Let your speech be with grace. Always season with salt, baby. Yeah, that way you're able to answer. You're able to give the right words. You're able to talk to the people so that they can understand and they can really see the light that shines within you, seeing your good works and giving God glory. But don't take my word for a family. Y'all get into this word for yourself. That's Colossians chapter 4, verses 2 through 6. And when you read your word, jump into the comment box and say, I read my word. Y'all remember, man, we still screaming the same thing. Faith over fear. God over everything. Together we have made love great again, because love has never lost its power. It just lost its popularity, and we are here, man. Shout out to those who are still logging on, man. Pastor Honor, I see you on here. Clee, but you know I love you, man. I love you, man. I love you, bruh. I love you. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. I see you on here, Latour. Good morning to y'all. It is morning time. Y'all remember, please, y'all read y'all word. Jump in the comment box and say, I read my word, because it's not about me. It's about me bringing the word in a way that you will get closer to him. I love y'all. God bless you. It is morning time, y'all. It is morning time. If you don't mind, man, hit the share button. Let's get the message out to as many people as possible. I'll catch y'all on the next time. It is morning time, family. Catch y'all later.